टुडेज टॉपिक इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू मेटाजुआ एंड सिस्टोड. टिनिया स्पीसीज एंड डी लेटम. सो टुडे वी विल सी द फर्स्ट इंट्रोडक्शन टू मेटाजुआ. मेटाजुआंस आर मल्टी सेल्युलर ऑर्गेनिजम्स. एनिमल्स इन द किंगडम्स आर एनिमलिया, बिलीव टू हैव evolved from protozoan, specially coenoflagellates. Characteristics: they are eukaryotic heterotrophs, polarized along an anterior posterior locomotory axis, mostly motile. Ground plan: they have a specialized cell organized as a tissue. Primary tissue has epithelial and connective. Epithelium: sheets of cells bound to each other by shell adhesion molecules. Figure shows first oral and aboral site, then radial symmetry, then bilateral symmetry. Ontogeny: origin of being, development of an organism. Zygote formed by the union of egg and sperm nuclei. Multicellular embryo is formed in a process that is known as a cleavage or division. This shows division. Embryo development: blastula, one cell layer, thick hollow ball or solid ball of cells. Gastrulation, invagination of one cell of blastula greater than two layered blastula. Then morphogenesis, ectoderm and endoderm from around gelatinous blastocysts. Figure shows first day, first cell stage in zygote, 1.5 days, 2 cell stage, second day, 4 cell stage, third day, 8 cell stage, 4 day, morula, 5 day, blastocyte. 4 cells, 8 cell, 28 cells. Cells, tissue and skeletons. Protozoan possess very little specializations. Most protozoan rely on organelle to carry out all functions. Differentiate tissue types allow for a partitioning of labor. Damaged cell can be regenerated. However, if a paramecium is damaged, the whole organism dies. This shows tear film, glycocalyx, microvilli, superficial cell, wing cell, basal cells, basal lamina, desmosomes. Indirect development: life cycle includes larval stage. Larva is independent stage with different anatomy and like biphasic file life cycles, benthic adults and planktiotic larva. Larva settles and undergoes metamorphosis into an immature juvenile. This shows direct development. Embryo develops directly into the juvenile without the larva stage, considered to be a derived trait, and indirect development with the excision and planktonic larva is the ancestral pattern. This shows reproductive adaptations. It improves chances of fertilization and embryo survival, increased synchrony and proximity. Hermaphrodites common in species with small population densities and sessile lifestyles. Any nearby individual is potentially mate. Most hermaphrodites cross fertilization then self fertilize. Maternal provision: oviparous and viviparous. Oviparous gives birth by ovum or by egg. Viviparous will give the birth directly to the child. Adaptation providing physical protection and nutrition to offspring are very valuable. oviparous, egg-swept, spout. Before or just after fertilization, viviparous, internal fertilization, embryos, gestate in maternal body and release larva and juveniles. Brooding, eggs released from mother but are retained on or taken back to her body. Functional consequence of body sizes, most metazoans are 0.5 mm to 1 mm in size. Prokaryote cells, protozoans, grapefruit, animal stadium. Cell specialization improve efficiency, requires functional compartmentalizations and cellular integrations. Size, surface and volume. It is significantly affected by increase in the body size. As a cell grows larger, its area is squared and its volume is cubed. Supply will not be able to support cell volume demand. Limits exchange of gases, nutrients and wastes. Size and transport. Rates of diffusion slows drastically over great distance. Effective diffusion distance is roughly 0.5 mm for most animals. Body diameters larger than 1 mm may be diffusions limited. Circulatory system needs for body larger than 1 mm in diameter. Size and metabolism. Metabolic rate increase with body size. Poikilothermous, cold-blooded animals consume 8 times more mass-specific energy than protozoans. Homeotherms, mammals and birds consume 29 times more energy than a poikilotherm of equal term. Number cells are function of metabolic rate, the number of cells relative metabolic rate. Motility rate as function of metabolic rate. Advantage of large body size is mass specific decrease in a metabolic rate, reduced risk of prediction of protozoan. Large metazoans can prey upon protozoans. Motile metazoans move faster than protozoans. Multicellularity allows ability to regain. Natural selections. Heterochorony changes in the timing of developmental events allow potential for evolutionary changes. Two type of heterochorony and pedomorphosis and paramorphosis occur. This shows fever, fish, salamander, tortoise, chick, pig, calf, rabbit and human. Pedomorphosis, a trait of descended species resembles an in smaller and simpler descended with short generation times, common in species living in unpredictable or changes environment, adapted to colonize entirely new habits. Paramorphous, trait of descended species that develop beyond the ancestral trait, result in larger and more complex descended with large generation times, favored in constant or predictable environment. Larger body size is a major trend in protozoan evolution. Origin of metazoa, flattening of cells, cells push inward and arachnotary form. Colonial theory. Metazoans are derived from colonial flagellate protozoans. Cholangioflagellate and metazoa are sister taxa. Spherical colony of flagellated cell divided by mitosis but daughter cell held within a ECM. Archaeocytes, contractile cells, germ cells, archaeocytes and germ cells, skeletal cells and epithelial cells. Now we will see about introduction to cystodes, Diphyllobacterium species and Tinea species. The learning objectives in this topics are causative agents, life cycles, pathogenesis, clinical feature complications, epidemiology, lab diagnosis, treatment and preventions. Classification of cystoids based on their habitats. They are intestinal cystoids and tissue cystoids or somatic cystoids. Intestinal examples are Diphyllobothrium tineus oleum saginata causing intestinal tineasis, H. nana hymenolepis species. Somatic tissue cystoids, they are larval form. They are found in human muscles or organ. Examples include Tineus oleum causing cysticercosis, Tinea multiceps, Echinococcus species. The agent of hydatid disease affecting liver. Classifications: Pseudophyllidian and Cyclophyllidian. Family are Diphyllobothridia, genus Diphyllobothrium, Spirometra. Cyclophyllidian: Tinidia, Tinea, Echinococcus, Hymenolepididia, Hymenolepis, Diploidia and Diplodidia. Morphology: Two forms, adult form. Adult form found in intestine of man. Shape: figure shows, long, flattened, segmented, dorsoventrally flattened. Tap-like forms, hence also called as a tapeworm. Size: few millimeter to several meters. Body structure: adult worm consists of three parts: head or scolex, neck region, and strobila. Figure shows hooklets or ostellums, suckers, neck region, immature proglottids, mature proglottids, and gravid proglottids. They are the strobilas. Eggs are released into the uterus following fertilization and fill the gravid proglottids. This shows pseudophyllidian cystoids, operculum is here, cyclophyllidian cystoids. B and C has cyclophyllidian cystoid. After C losses the it losses the eggs. It is operculum, knob. Then before loss of eggshells, they have embryo, three pairs of hooklets, embryo four and egg cells. Larval form: larva of cyclophyllidian cystoids, cysticercus bovis, cysticercoid, cysticercus cellulosis, Oenoecium and hydatid cyst. Mature proglottids of cystoid, they are the A is pseudophyllidian cystoid, B is cyclophyllidian cystoids. Figure shows different areas of this cystoids like common genital pores, uterine pores, seminal vesicle, testicular follicles, vagina, vasa efferentia, vas deferentia, convoluted uterus, vitelline duct, seminal receptor, bilobed ovary, oviduct, vitelline duct. In cyclophyllidia, it is a vasa efferentia, vas deferens, serous, serous sac, common genital pole, vagina, O types, vitelline glands, seminal receptor, oviduct, bilobed ovary, testicular follicles, and branch uterus. What is the difference between pseudophyllidian and cyclophyllidian cystoids? As figure shows, in pseudophyllidian cystoids, colex bears two grooves, Brothia, Bothria. Cyclophyllidian cystoid bears four suckers. Some species bear ostellum with hooklets. Uterus is convoluted in pseudophyllidian cystoid, rosette shaped, unbranched, opens at the uterine pole. Cyclophyllidian cystoid branched and closed as a blind sex, no uterine pole. Genital pore situated ventrally in the midline. Cyclophyllidian cystoid is situated laterally. Vitelline glands scattered throughout the segment. Cyclophyllidian cystoid single mass behind ovary. Eggs covered by one layer egg cells. Freshly passed egg in feces are unembryonated. Eggs are operculated and embryo is ciliated. In cyclophyllidian cystoid covered by two layers, egg cell and embryo four. Embryonated form from the beginning and eggs are not operculated and embryo is not ciliated. Larval form is solid in pseudophyllidian cystoid and in cyclophyllidian cystoid it contains bladder like cells. So first of all, Diphyllobothrium species. Diphyllobothrium latum is the largest known parasite found in human intestine. It is known as a feast tapeworm. Epidemiology: infection occurs worldwide, very rare in India. Three cases of this infection have been reported so far for the South India in Vellore, Pondicherry and Karimnagar. Habitat small intestine in jejunum and duodenum. Morphology, adult worm. D-latum is the largest tapeworm infection infecting man, measuring up to 15 meter or more than over 3000 proglotids. It consists of head, neck and body. Strobila are more than 3000 segments divided into immature, mature and gravid segments. Mature segment is broader than longer and contains male and the female reproductive organs. Gravid segment, uterus is filled with egg which are discharged periodically through the uterine pore. Eggs. Fertilized eggs are oval, measuring 58 to 75 micrometer length and 40 to 50 micrometer width. Eggs are operculated at one end and bear a knob at the other end. Embryonated eggs contain hexacanth oncosphere lined by a ciliated membrane. Larva, three larval stages, first stage, second stage and a third stage. In first stage larva, it is a coracidium larva, figure shows. Second is prosarcoid and third is pleurosarcoid larva. Life cycle, men acquire infection by ingestion of undercooked fish containing pleurosarcoid larva, that is the third stage of larva. Man is the definitive host. Pleurosarcoid larva is liberated in intestine, develops into an adult worm, then attaches to the mucosa of small intestine. Fertilization occurs. Operculated eggs develop 10 to 12 days. Embryonated egg in fresh or marine water, then coracidium in the fresh or marine water. First stage larva, after 12 hours, second stage larva develops. Coracidium in body cavity of cyclops transformed to prosarcoid larva. After 2 to 3 weeks, second stage larva are digested by prosarcoid in a feces and second intermediate host phase. Then after 1 to 2 weeks, pleurosarcoid third stage larva in muscle or viscera, and men acquire infection by eating undercooked fish or containing pleurosarcoid larva. Cycle is repeated. Pathogenesis and clinical feature. Most of the D-latum infection are asymptomatic: abdominal discomfort, diarrhea, vomiting, weakness and weight loss, or rarely intestinal obstructions, cholangitis or polycystitis. Vitamin B deficiency. It causes dissociation of vitamin B12, intrinsic factor complex within the gut lumen, and leads to development of megaloblastic anemia. By laboratory diagnosis, stool examination. Eggs in the stool, characteristics, surrounded by an eggshell and operculum at one end and a knob at the other end. Eggs are bile stained, do not float in saturated salt solution. Proglotids may be discharged in the stool in some cases. Figure shows caramine stained gravid proglotids of D. latum. Praziquintal is a highly effective drug of choice for treatment, than niclosamide, alternatively parenteral vitamin B12 to be given. Then cyclophyllidians stored. In this we will see the tinea species, Echinospecies and Hymenolepis species. Tinea species classification. Tinea species pathogenic to humans. Two types, T. saginata and Solium. T. saginata is beef tapeworm and intestinal tineasis. T. Solium, intestinal tineasis and cysticercosis, pork tapeworm. What is the difference? In Tinea saginata, definitive host man. T. solium, man, intermediate host cattle. Organ affected, intestine and diseases, intestinal tineasis. In T. solium, definitive host man, intermediate host may be pig or man. If intermediate host is pig, organ affected is intestine and disease, intestinal tineasis. If intermediate host is man, then organ affected muscle, CNS and eye, and disease is cysticercosis. Habitat, they reside in small intestine. Larva of T. solium reside and cystic lesions in the muscle, brain and eyes. Morphology, morphological form are adult form, egg and larva. Adult form is already defined before, that is booklets on rostellum, suckers, Pigasus, neck region, and strobila. Strobila contains immature proglottids, mature proglottids, and gravid proglottids. In Pigasus, T. saginata and solium, the solium has rostellum hooklets, two rows of hooklets is here, and suckers, they are four in numbers. Features. Difference between Tinea saginata and solium according to the features. In adult swarm, length is 4 to 6 meter or more in Tinea saginata, 2 to 4 meters in Tinea solium. Head and scolex of Tinea saginata, that is larger and quadrangle, four suckers presents which may be pigmented. It has no rostellum and no hooklets. Whereas in Tinea solium, head and scolex is small and globular. It has four suckers present but not pigmented. It bears rostellum with two rows of hooklets, hence called as a arm tapeworm. Neck region in Tinea solium is longer, and in Tinea saginata neck region is longer and solium is shorter. Eggs. Egg shells, round in shape, 30 to 40 micrometer, covered by two layers, embryo, oncosphere. Eggs of both Tinea species are mostly similar. Larva, Tinea saginata, sister Circus bovis, Pigasus, found in a cattle muscle, not in man. This is Tinea solium, sister Circus cellulosus, present in pig's muscle and also in man. Life cycle of Tinea saginata, host is, definitive host is man, intermediate host is cattle. Infective stage, Cysticercus bovis in man and eggs in cattles. It has human cycle and cattle cycles. Man acquire infection by ingestion of undercooked beef containing Cysticercus bovis. Scolex are exvaginates and entrance to intestine, developed into the adult worm in small intestine. After 10 to 14 weeks, fertilization occurs, egg in the feces appears. Cycle in man is completed, now cycle in cattle. Eggs are ingested by cattle. Oncosphere hatches out and penetrates intestine, circulates Cysticercus bovis in skeletal muscle. Then man acquire infection by ingestion of undercooked beef containing Cysticercus bovis. Cycle is repeated. Life cycle of T. solium depends on the disease, intestinal or cysticercosis. Man acquire infection by ingestion of undercooked pork containing Cysticercus cellulosus. Scolex, exvaginates and encroaches to intestine, development into the adult worm, fertilization occurs in man. Then in pig, eggs in feces, eggs are invaginated by pigs in circulation, develops into the Cysticercus in muscles. Then eggs in feces, ingestion of contaminated food or water with eggs, developed into the Cysticercus in man, CNS, IGN muscle. External aorta infections, eggs are ingested by unhygienic personal habitats, oncosphere hatches out and penetrates into the intestine, developed into the Cysticercus in man. Then internal aorta infections, eggs are thrown back to stomach by reverse peristalsis. Then oncosphere hatches out and penetrates into the intestine and develop into the Cysticercus in man, in CNS, eye and muscles. This is the form of Cysticercosis in man. Cysticercus bovis in skeletal muscle, Pigasus, and in man, CNS, eye and muscles. In muscles, size is 6 to 9 mm, round, grayish worm containing invaginated scolex without hooklets, figure are here, and in CNS eye and muscle it is 0.5 to 1.5 centimeter spherical, yellowish white, outer bladder like sac filled with vesicular fluid, inner chamber contain roving scolex with hooklets. Pathogenesis and clinical feature. Intestinal tinea is asymptomatic passage of proglottids in their faces. Mild abdominal discomfort, loss of appetite, change in bowel habit. Occasional obstruction by migrating proglottids, appendicitis or cholangitis. Cysticercosis. Clinical feature depends on the cyst locations. Subcutaneous cysticercosis is palpable nodules. Muscular is muscle pain, weakness, ocular cause proptosis, diplopia, loss of visions, and neurocysticercosis. Most common from 60 to 90% cases of cysticercosis. Parasitic CNS infection of men and adult onset epilepsy throughout the world. NCC is of two types, parenchymal and extraparenchymal. Parenchymal brain involves parenchymal and extraparenchymal site are meningitis, meninges, ventricles and spinal cord. Subarachnoid species, brain parenchyma. It can be asymptomatic to various manifestations like seizure, hydrocephalus, increased intracranial pressure, chronic meningitis, focal neurological deficits, psychological disorder and dementia. Clinical presentation may be variable, depends on the number, location, size of the cyst and morphological stage of the cyst and the host immune response. Epidemiology of cysticercosis in India is the most common parasitic CNS infection of men. Most common cause of adult onset epilepsy. Recent studies suggest the disease burden in India is 18 to 31% of suspected cases of epilepsy. It appears to be more prevalent in various places like Bangalore, Delhi, Vellore, Bihar, UP, Pondicherry and Chandigarh. Lab diagnosis of intestinal tinnitus by stool examination. It may be segments, eggs or proglottids. Tinea sugenita solium. Number of proglottids in Tinea sugenita 1000 to 2000. Tinea solium 800 to 1000. Uterus bears in 15 to 20 lateral branches in Tinea sugenita. Tinea solium it bears in 7 to 13 lateral branches. Lobes of ovary 2, no accessory lobe. And Tinea solium it is 3, 2 lobes with an accessory lobe. Testes 300 to 400 follicles. In Tinea sugenita, Tinea solium 150 to 200 follicles. Vaginal sphincter is only present in T. sugenita. Expulsion of segments, single in the species, feces in Tinea sugenita. Chain of 5 to 6 segment in Tinea solium. Tinea specific antigen detections in stool, copra antigen by ELISA. Advantage is more sensitive than stool examination and can be detected. Carrier stage. It cannot differentiate Tinea sugenita and solium. Antibody detection by precipitation, agglutination, CFT and ELISA. Limitation cannot differentiate between present and past infection. Newer advances recently immunoblot is developed for T. solium specific antibodies. Claims 95% specific and 100% specific. 95% sensitive and 100% specificity. Molecular method is DNA probe and PCR. Cysticercosis, radio diagnosis imaging method by CT and MRI. Figure shows hypodense area, cysticerci, and hyperdense eccentric area inside the vesicle scolex. Antigen detection by ELISA. Then histopathological examination, cysticerci can be detected in muscle, eye, subcutaneous tissue by biopsy following surgical removal or FNAC of the cyst followed by microscopic demonstration of parasites. Del Bruto diagnosis criteria for human cysticercosis, it is based on clinical imaging, immunological and epidemiological absolute criteria, major, minor and epidemiological criteria. Treatment, praziquantel is a drug of choice. Then, niclosamide is also effective but not widely available. Cysticercosis, antiparasitic agent for brain parenchymal is an albendazole, praziquantel. Longer course are often needed in patients with multiple subarachnoid cysticerci. Surgery, open craniotomy to remove cysticerci is rarely required nowadays. Surgery is indicated for ocular and spinal and ventricular lesion because antiparasitic drugs can provoke irreversible inflammatory damage. Prevention: intestinal tinnitus, adequate cooking of beef or pork, refrigeration or salting for long periods, or freezing at -10°C for 9 days. Effective fecal disposal to prevent infection to cattle and pigs. Cysticercosis: good personal hygiene to prevent auto infections. With egg: effective fecal disposal to prevent contamination of food and water with eggs. Treatment and prevention of human intestinal infections. Thank you.